We've got six birds on the team today. They're named after the villains, so this is the group of villains that we're flying this afternoon. We've got Jack Sparrow, who's kind of the leader of the group. And we've got the Sundance Kid, Butch Cassidy, Fagin, Captain Thunderbolt. We've also got a little bird called Hetty as well. So all the same species, all hooded vultures, but there are a variety of different ages. The older these birds get, the whiter their head becomes. They've got a hood of white feathering, whereas when they're babies, they've got a brown head of feathers. And we've got one juvenile bird in and amongst this group today, so you'll see when we come a little bit closer. We do a lot of work with vultures in the wild. In fact, the main aim for us being here is to help birds of prey out. You know? And we're heavily involved in conservation here at the Trust, whether it be kites, releasing them into the wild, which we've done over the years, or putting up boxes for kestrels and barn owls to rear their young, or working with vultures overseas. You know, our aim is, you know, everything that we do here, events, shows, different things throughout the year, is to raise money to put back into bird of prey conservation. So we're a charity. So every little bit helps. And vultures always need a little bit of extra help, I find, you know, because they are in decline. Vultures all across the world are in decline for lots of different reasons. So our aim is to try and help them out. So first way of doing that is to get people on our side when it comes to liking vultures. So we're going to now give you the full vulture experience. The first vulture's already here, but the rest of them will follow. The guys are heading up as well, and they're heading in to pick out their next victims. Look at this, loitering around outside of the arena. First vulture on its way across the tops of your heads. Get ready to duck very low, but yeah. Two more birds come over on this side, and for the next 5 minutes or so, they're going to be flying backwards and forwards at very low level. So we've got five birds on that side, and another head. All six birds are on that side of the arena. Next bird's taken off, and another one is on. It's very low level. Get ready to go extra low. I normally find that we get the most screams throughout this part of the demonstration, because they do come in pretty fine. In fact, we had some of the tears just there. I have to say, not particularly proud of it, but showed a little bit of a phobia of birds. And she did, but I did sort of think, I didn't say out loud, but I thought, well, what are you doing here if you've got a phobia of birds? And it turned out that six heavy vultures and some of them a phobia of birds was not a good mix. So it didn't work very well, but they do cut it very fine. Gives you an idea, I think, of what it's like to fly with vultures. I mean, literally, we're at their level, aren't we? Or they're at our level. Normally, vultures fly very, very high, you know, searching for carrion out in open areas. These often mixed with other species of vultures, you know, so they'll fly hundreds and thousands of feet high. They've got incredible eyesight. It's thought that most birds of prey have got about 10 times better eyesight than us, than a human. And that's in detail and resolution, so they can spot the tiniest bit of food from way, way up in the sky. And some of the highest recorded birds there are, as far as flying is concerned. There's been records of vultures flying at over 30,000 feet in the air. Yeah, it's just incredible. Okay, coming across now, top of your head, excellent stuff. Now, where you find one vulture, you'll find others. You can see these all stick together, they're a real group bird. You often find other species of vultures as well, sort of hanging about with them. So, what are we going to do now? We're going to let the hooded vultures go for a bit of a fly, so you don't have to duck quite as much. And if you cast your eyes to the right-hand side of our arena, in a few moments' time, we're going to be joined by one of the largest vultures that you'll find in Africa. Her name is Sitara. Sitara is a white-headed vulture. Here she comes now, look at this. Wingspan of nearly 7 foot from tip to tip. Coming in right across this section of the audience, duck very low as she comes over. Wow! Very good. She's like a flying barn door. Now, they're a very interesting species of vulture, these. And they are a vulture, you know, so they're a carrion feeder. You would often see these birds hanging around these hooded vultures and vice versa, all feeding together off of carcasses. But they're kind of a bird of two halves. These vultures are also one of the very few vultures that have been recorded to show predatory behaviour. They've been witnessed hunting in pairs, almost like eagles do, catching squirrels and any sort of small mammals out in Africa. So they're almost like this sort of missing link between vultures and eagles. And if you look at her as well, when she next comes into the back of the round with Mike here, who's flying her, she doesn't really look like your classic vulture. You know, she hasn't got the long, bald head and neck. She's got quite a lot of feathering around her head. And even the shape of her and the shape of her feet, very powerful feet, almost more eagle-like than vulture-like. You know, so they're a bit of an in-between species. Look right up behind us as well. We've got a buzzard flying around above us. Not ours, completely wild. European buzzard. Just come over for a little look. Often our birds are a bit of an attraction to the wild birds, so they all kind of sort of group together and have a bit of a fly around. Okay, so we've got hooded vultures flying everywhere. We've got Sotaris out the back here. She goes bright red when she comes out to work. A lot of vultures do, when they're feeding and when they're in a group, all feeding together, a bit of a communication thing, they go bright red. Almost blushing, which is pretty cool to see. White wings there denote that it's a female, whereas the males have got a grey pattern on their wings, and amazing soarers, you know, fantastic flyers. Anyway, do you want to see some more birds?
Yeah?
So that's seven vultures we've got out of the minute, but now what we're going to do is we're going to let the lot out. It's such a nice day for flying. So if you look now, we've got some more birds entering the arena en masse. In fact, we've got over 20 birds that are now entering the arena. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be quiet, we're going to play a piece of music, and you can just sit back and enjoy watching everybody fly. Everyone just enjoying themselves out there. We've got a real array of birds out now. The vultures are still flying at low level, which you probably notice every now and again. Here they come again. We've got Sotara coming in from the back here. We're having a good fly around. You can see she sort of follows the other birds around because she needs good lift in order to make flying easy for herself. So normally where these kites are flying, these are a team of kites that are out here today, she'll kind of follow them because they're really good at finding lift, you know, so she's kind of worked that out over the years. The kites that we're flying this afternoon are a very close relation to the red kites that you find in the UK. They're called black kites, they're a European species. Very rarely do you see them in this country, although very early spring there have been the odd black kites spotted in the UK, but they're not an indigenous species. They live in big groups, very much like vultures, great scavengers, but they're also predatory as well. And kites are renowned for their insect-feeding behaviour. So, actually, we're going to see if we can try and show you this now. So, Miriam's coming out to the arena. She's going to throw up little bits of food for the kites to catch. Not only can they catch the food, they can feed whilst they're flying. Look at this. And you saw this earlier on today, if you watched the first show, we had a little African kite out on his own flying around with the vultures. But, you know, when you see him en masse like this, it becomes a bit of a feeding frenzy. And there's just birds from all angles catching food. And this is how what they're like in the wild. They'll cut through swarms of insects, catching and feeding, trying to make life easy. Look at these vultures flying up above us still. Team Vulture are still going. Look at this. But they can't catch food, so they'll just keep flying. Amazing birds. More kites coming in. We've got a team of 13 kites out today. Most of them are related, ranging from just over a year old, the youngest, to just over 20 years old, is the oldest bird flying here today. So Mike's out as well, rewarding the kites. We've got so many, and everybody needs to be looked after. So